Hey, welcome to All Play Games Weekly, where we bring you your weekly dose of tech news, games, and inspiration. I'm Brian Karsten.
I'm William DiPicari.
Let's get into it. The new Bose audio glasses retail at $199 and come in two styles, sharp or round edges for you. Bose claims that others around you aren't going to be able to hear the music, and it's going to come through clearly just to you. So that's my biggest concern, right? If music is playing through and everyone on the bus or train is hearing it, they're not going to work. But if they can pull this off, I think it's going to be a huge innovation that will take one apparatus off your plate when walking out the door each day. What do you think, Will?
I understand the practicality behind them. Yeah. Am I a first generation adopter? Probably not. But what I will tell you is that I am a huge Bose brand guy. So with that being said, they might come across my table, you know, in the next year or two. I'm curious about them. I'm curious. I want to know more.
Well, we'll check them out then. So, next up, we have the Nreal Mixed Reality Glasses that retail for $499 beginning in early 2020. These glasses are lightweight, coming in at only 88 grams, and connect via USB-C to your smartphone or Nreal controller for a mixed reality experience at 1080p resolution. The glasses provide a 52-degree field of vision, allowing for a 72-inch mixed reality screen for watching videos or gaming. Check them out at nreal.ai now. So, Will, do you think you'd sit at home and use these glasses for entertainment experiences?
Yeah, I think I would. I think it's kind of the next evolution of kind of putting a VR headset on you at home. You kind of see people with the Oculus Quest out there now in the airports, and they're sitting there in an airport with a headset on.
Yeah,
and so
it's too much.
I kind of think this is the next step of that.
Yep,
so as far as being able to put that HUD right up in front of your eyeballs, I mean, let's just put eyeballs, digital eyeballs inside of ourselves, right? Like, that's the next
thing,
right?
That is, that, yeah.
Just right on the eyeballs?
Yeah, but this is a step.
Cyberpunk?
All right, moving on to Stadia, Will. So tell us a little bit about Stadia. What do you think?
All right, so you guys know Stadia Founders Edition is coming out here pretty soon. Price tag is $129.99. We're probably going to pick one up. We're excited about it. We're looking forward to all the perks and the attributes that it's going to have. But here's the $1 million kicker. In case you didn't know, it requires an internet connection. You say, William, is our internet really that good around the United States? And the answer is, it's not. Here's the reason why, guys. Check it out. If fiber were something that we actually had an infrastructure of and were able to expand into our different major metropolitan cities, what we could do then is we could really kick those speeds up. ISPs would then be able to force to actually increase all other stuff. We get better benefits from that. Stadia requires 25 megabyte download speeds and 5 upload speeds just to be able to basically get their 1080p 60 frames per second service.
Gotta get that.
Here in Portland, we don't really have that problem. I know other major metropolitan cities don't really have that problem either, but guess what? Middle America, out in, you know, the middle states, guys, don't necessarily
that.
So we're not fully there as an infrastructure yet. So guys, I am looking forward to Stadia, but when it comes to that fiber optic stuff, China actually has 7 lines coming from China to the United States. One of those lines carries 2 billion, about 2 billion phone calls.
That's insane.
Understand the power behind it. So
that's crazy.
We're looking forward to it, but at the same time, internet's got to get better.
Now for our gaming tip of the week, we have Pearson Guest, who is on today. He is a grandmaster in Overwatch. He plays on PC, and he's going to provide us with our tip of the week for new players and players that have kind of been stuck in a low elo for a long period of time. Pierce, what's your best tip to get these guys to have a great experience in this new 2-2-2 meta that Overwatch has just put out with their latest patch? What do you think, bud?
So what's a great practice schedule for our Overwatch players out there?
Yeah, so it's not really a schedule. It's just like, if I decide to play Overwatch, even after playing for 3 years and being relatively okay at this game, I pop onto the training ground first and I play the heroes I think I'm going to want to play. I try them out in training ground and I make sure I start to feel how I play a lot of projectile heroes, and projectiles go at different speeds and they have different bounces. If you're playing Junkrat, his firing mechanic is far different than Pharah, both characters which I like a lot.
Thank you, Pierce, for all your great insight. And now to send all you pioneers out there with a little quote of the week, a little inspiration for you from our Stoic Gandhi.
Pretty simple. You cannot shake hands with a clenched fist. Let's try. Did we evolve something there? Let's not get into it. Guys, the point is that you need to extend that hand. So do so. Extend that hand to those around you and help create a positive reality for our society. And before we jump out of here, check us out at PAX. We're going to be up there the weekend, end of August. We're actually looking forward to the keynote speaker. Gary Whitta is going to be up there, the writer of Rogue One. He's on Kinda Funny Games Daily a lot. He's a great personality. He's a great human being. He's the perfect person to kick off this keynote speech. So
I'm really excited to see it. Oh, yeah, that's going to be a blast. So from all of us to you, be well, Pioneers.